Malole soifua, o te whaatalofa atu, i le suafa pa ia, o lo tātua li'i o Yesu Keriso, o lo'u ingoa o ne maia faletongo. E avea au, e whai masui o le au whainga luenga, e momoli atu se upu whaamalosi au, i le nei tai au. Whaapitai le mai moa mai, i le tātou morning mana, mo le nei aso. Good morning to my family, and thank you for joining us on Morning Manna. I want to welcome each and every one of you, and I pray that you are having a blessed morning so far, and I am so thankful to be here. My name is Nehemiah Faletomo, and I am one of the conference evangelists here with the Washington Conference in Washington State. I'm happy to be able to have the opportunity this morning to share the Word of God with all of us. Before I share the Word, I ask that you would join me for a word of prayer. Father in heaven, Lord, thank you so much for waking us up this morning, for giving us life and health and strength. We pray now for the Holy Spirit to be with us, to illuminate our minds and to teach us your word. I pray that Jesus will be lifted up, that he will be glorified, that he will draw all of us to himself, that by being drawn to him and being in his presence, we might be changed from glory to glory. Lord, bless your word now. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. This message comes to us this morning from the book of Romans, the book of Romans chapter 5, and the title of my message is While We Were Yet Sinners. While We Were Yet Sinners, that is the title of my message for this morning. And I'm going to focus in on Romans chapter 5, verses 6, 8, and 10. Romans chapter 5, verses 6, 8, and 10. I want to share with you that it reveals to us four conditions of the human family. Four conditions. It points out four conditions. Notice what it says beginning in verse 6. Romans chapter 5, verse 6, the Bible says this. For when we were yet without strength, in due time, Christ died for the ungodly. Verse 8, it says, But God commendeth his love toward us, in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Verse 10, For if, when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his Son, much more, being reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. I also want to read it in the Samoan Bible for all of us this morning. E mau mai lea I le tusi o Roma. E mau mai lea I le tusi o Roma. Roma, lona mata upu e lima, fuai upu e ono, valu, ma le sefulu. In verse 6 it says here, Awa na maliu kiriso, iono po e te tauai, Ino o vai vai pea I tātou, o le sui o ia, o e whaale matau. Let me read that one more time. O wā na maliu ke riso, I ono pō e te tauai. Ina o vai vai pea I tātou, o le sui o ia, o e whaale matau. And then in verse 8 it says, Aua whaali, Aua whaali tinoina mai e lea tua lona lava alofa ia te I tātou. Ina ua maliu kiriso masui o I tātou a o tātou angasala, a o tātou angasala pea. And there's the message that I'm sharing with all of us this morning that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Verse 10. Awa a whai ua le lei I tātou ma lea tua. I le maliu o lona alo, ina o whai I tātou monofili. E matua whaola ina a lava, whaola ina lava, I tātou I lona soifua, o I tātou ua le lei ma ia. So there you have it. I did my best to read it in, you know, whasamoa. But the message I want to share is that the Bible in the book of Romans, first of all, makes clear our condition. It makes clear our condition. Did you notice what it says in verse 6? In verse 6, it says here, When we were yet without strength, it says, in due time, Christ died for the ungodly. And so, beloved, what I want to share with you is that right there in that verse, it mentions two of our conditions, two of the human conditions. It mentions that, first of all, we are without strength. We are without strength. We have no power. We have no strength or any power within ourselves to change and to save ourselves. We have no power or strength within ourselves, of ourselves, to change and save ourselves. And then it also points out that we are also ungodly, ungodly. So that means that we are not Christ-like. We are not Christ-like. We are ungodly. So right there, you have the first two conditions that are mentioned there in the book of Romans. It says that we are without strength. We are helpless. We are powerless. We cannot change ourselves or save ourselves from the pit of sin, from the power of sin. We don't have that power. And then it also says that we are ungodly, beloved. It says that we are ungodly. And then over here in verse 8, it says, but God commendeth, also means demonstrated. God commended or demonstrated his love toward us in that while we were yet righteous, is that what your Bible says? No, the Bible doesn't say that. The Bible says that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Christ died for us. So beloved, check this out. Right there we have condition number 3. It says that first of all, we were without strength. And then it says that we are ungodly, right? Ungodly. And then it says that we are sinners. We are sinners. Okay? Fasamo, it says, Namaliu Yesu Moitato Aotato Angasalapel. So it says that God demonstrated his love towards us and extended his grace towards us while we were yet sinners, while we were without strength, helpless, powerless, while we were ungodly. It said that God demonstrated his love toward us and that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Now I got one more here in verse 10. In verse 10, it says here, for if when we were enemies, we were reconciled to God by the death of his son, much more being reconciled, we shall be saved by his life. Oh, praise be to God. Praise be to God for that word. So notice the fourth one. The fourth one is we were enemies of God. We are enemies of God. And listen, beloved, the Bible makes it clear here that it's not God himself that wants to be our enemy. But because we are without power, because we are helpless, powerless, because we are ungodly, unchristlike, and it says that we are sinners, we actually look at God as being the enemy. We actually view him as being the enemy. You see, we must understand that what the devil has done is he has duped humanity. He has deceived humanity. He has caused humanity to look upon God as being the enemy, as being the enemy, as being the cause of sin, sickness, suffering, disease, and death. He has caused man to look upon his maker, upon his creator, upon his redeemer as being the enemy. And yet, in spite of how we view God and how we looked at God, God still loved us. God still demonstrated his love toward us while we viewed him as being the enemy. The question I have to ask is, when's the last time an enemy came to save you? When's the last time an enemy gave his life for you? When's the last time an enemy did anything for you? I want to share with you, beloved, that we are saved by the enemy. If I may put it that way, we are saved by the enemy. But what I'm really pointing out here is the amazing love of God and the demonstration of the love of God toward each and every one of us while we were without strength, while we were helpless, powerless, and while we are ungodly, while we are sinners, while we viewed him as the enemy. God demonstrated his love for us by giving his son Jesus Christ to die on the cross for us while we have all these conditions. You know what that says to me? That tells me that God lavishes his love and his grace upon sinners. He lavishes his love and his grace upon those who are without strength. He lavishes his grace and his love upon those who are ungodly. He lavishes his grace and his love upon those that consider him to be their enemy. And so, beloved, I want to share with you that, you know, when we have people, when we are sharing the love of God with people, please, please let us view and understand what God has done for us. And that we in turn must also look at others that are going through the same thing. Others who may visit our church, others who may be in close proximity to us, others that we may have an opportunity to minister to, that even though they are without strength, even though they are ungodly, even though they are sinners, even though they view God as the enemy, we must love them. We must embrace them. We must welcome them. Why? Because, beloved, we are all in that same boat. And I want to share with you that I'm so thankful and I praise God. I praise God that because of that demonstration, because of that amazing demonstration of his love towards us while we were helpless, while we were without strength, while we were powerless, while we were ungodly, while we were sinners, while we viewed him as the enemy, that did not stop God from loving us. That did not stop God from pursuing us. That did not stop God from chasing us. That did not stop God from coming after us. Beloved, I want to share with you that nothing could deter him. Nothing could keep Jesus from us. He loved us so much that he came into this world. He came into this world and listen, he knew our helpless condition. He knew that we were without strength. He knew that we were ungodly. He knew that we were sinners. He knew that we looked at him as the enemy, beloved. But listen, I'm so thankful for a God who came down and demonstrated the greatest love that could ever be witnessed and ever experienced. And that was when he gave his only begotten son for each and every one of us. And I want to say it again, both in the English and in the, you know, Fasamo, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Namaliu Yesu Moitato Autato Amasalepea. And so, beloved, praise God for such a love. Would you say amen? Praise God for such a love. Now we in turn, because we have experienced that love, that grace, that mercy, the saving power of God, we in turn must also share that this God with others, beloved. And I always share with folks that come to visit church, or when we're out there in the community being the church, that if you are without strength, that if you are ungodly, that if you are sinners, that if you are an enemy of God, or you view God as an enemy, you are most welcome here. You are most welcome here, because these are the people that God lavishes his extravagant grace and love and mercy upon. I praise God. I thank Jesus that he did that for each and every one of us. And beloved, I want to share with you in closing, it says here, he who is trying to reach heaven by his own works in keeping the law is attempting an impossibility. Did you hear me, family? He who is trying to reach heaven by his own works in keeping the law is attempting an impossibility. There is no safety for one who has merely a legal religion, a form of godliness. The Christian's life is not a modification or improvement of the old, but a transformation of nature. There is a death to self and sin and a new life altogether. This change can be brought about only by the effectual working of the Holy Spirit. That comes out of Desire of Ages, page 172. Again, beloved, I'm so thankful, right? That the four conditions that are mentioned there that accurately describe our condition, the condition of the entire human race. Beloved, I'm so thankful that when we encounter Christ and encounter the love of God, that while we were yet sinners, and we believe that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. I want to share with you, beloved, that that's going to transform and change our hearts. After all, the theme of this month has been suinga, right? Change. And only God can bring that change to each and every one of our hearts. in our lives. Let us pray. Father in heaven, Lord, thank you so much for this time with my family. Thank you for the opportunity to share your word and to share your love. I pray, Lord, that in turn that we would take that same love, that same energy, that experience that we've had with you and share it with others. The greatest sermon that we can ever present, Lord, is a changed life, a life that has been changed and transformed by your grace and by your love, our testimony, our story, and Lord, to tell your story and how you do it and how you did it. Thank you, Lord, for my family. Bless each and every one of them. In Jesus' name, amen. I want to thank you, family, for joining me today. And just want to wish all of you a wonderful, wonderful day. And may the Lord bless and keep you. Yep. Have a blessed day. Tofa soifua.